गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन इंग्लिश लेक्चर। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द यूनिट 1 ऑफ योर इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न न्यू ग्रामर टॉपिक्स। ऑलरेडी we have studied the figures of speech. In figures of speech you have learned metaphor, simile and alliteration. So these three figures of speech we have already studied. Now today we are going to start with a new topic, that is transitive and intransitive verbs. So dear students, this topic already we have studied in previous year. In last year you all have studied this topic, transitive and intransitive verbs. So do you remember anything about last year, that what do transitive verb and intransitive verb mean? What is the difference between transitive and intransitive verb? Can anyone tell me what is the difference? So children, before trying to understand the concept of transitive and intransitive verb, let me introduce y'all what is verb. So what is verb, children? Already you have learned this in lower standard. Yes, a verb is a word that shows an action. A verb is a word that denotes an action. So examples are given on the image which is shown here. Jumping girl. So jumping is the action, that's why it is known as a verb. You can see on your screen these three examples. The another example is given in this picture, the baby sleeps. So sleeps is also an action. Action is going on, so it is known as a verb. A man eats a burger. So a man is eating a burger. So it is a nothing but known as a verb. So now let's study the difference between transitive verb and intransitive verb. First, understood the concept of verb? Very good. So students, on your mobile screen you can see here the image where the transitive verb and intransitive verb definition is given. So first let's study what is transitive verb. Transitive verbs are action verbs that have an object to receive that action. Dear students, in simple words, a transitive verbs take an object after it. For example, I bake some cookies. So children, first you have to identify the verb. Now what is verb here? Bake. So if bake is a verb, as the definition itself tells, that transitive verbs take an object after the verb. So after verb, is there any object in that example? Yes, cookies. So cookies is nothing but an object. So this sentence or this verb, bake, is known as transitive verb because it takes an object after it. Let's see the second example. I ride the bicycle. Now, dear children, in this sentence or in this example, the word ride is a verb because it denotes an action. And bicycle or the bicycle is an object. When verb takes an object after it is known as a transitive verb. So first you have to identify the verb. What is verb here? Ride. And after ride, the object is there. That's why it is said to be a transitive verb. Ride is said to be a transitive verb. Let's proceed to the intransitive verb. Intransitive verbs are action verbs, but unlike transitive verbs, they do not have an object receiving the action. So, in simple words, intransitive verbs does not take an object after the verb. For example, I laugh. So, laugh is an action. So, laugh is a verb. But can you see your object? No. So, there is no object after the verb laugh. So, it means the verb last, the verb laugh is an intransitive verb because it does not take an object after it. Second example, I cry. So, cry is an action. So, cry is a verb. But after the word cry or after the verb cry, there is no object given here. That's why cry is known as a intransitive verb. Why it is known as intransitive verb? Because there is no object after the verb cry. Next example, the book falls. So the book falls, children, this example, verb is falls. So just underline the word falls because it is a verb. Is there any object after it? No. So fall is nothing but an intransitive verb because it does not take object after it. Understood, students? Clear with the concept of transitive and intransitive verb? Let's see with the help of more examples. Keep two things in mind, that in transitive verb it needs a object. In picture itself you can see the transitive verb says that I need object, whereas vice versa, intransitive verb says that I don't need object. Intransitive verb says that there is no need of an object. So, in simple words, transitive verb takes object after it, after the verb, whereas intransitive verb does not take an object after the verb. Clear, students? So, students, the important thing you have to keep in mind. For example, transitive verb. Example is given, Sarah baked a cake. So, as you all know, baked is an action. So, baked is a verb. Second thing you have to do is you have to check whether the verb baked is transitive or intransitive. So, for that purpose, you need to ask question. Sarah baked what? You will get answer as a cake. Ultimately, you will get an answer, cake. Sarah baked what? A cake. also when you are framing the question on verb and you are getting an object as an answer, it is known as an intransitive verb. I repeat, when you are asking the question on verb or you are framing the question on verb, you will get the object as an answer, and that's known as transitive verb. When you are framing the question on verb and you get object as an answer is known as transitive verb. Now, what do you mean by intransitive verb? Let's see with the example. Nomi plays. So here in this sentence, plays is an action. So it is known as a verb. So you have to frame the question on this sentence. Nomi plays what? Is there any object? No. After verb, there is no object. So there is no question rising that you will get an object as an answer. There is no question to arise that you will get object as an answer, because after verb there is no object given. So it is known as intransitive verb. Second example, Dinah is a doctor. Now here there will be a bit confusion for you all that there is no action verb here. So students, always keep one thing in mind: when there is no action verb, when there is absence of action verb, there is always a helping verb. Now what do you mean by helping verb? So children, here are the helping verbs. Helping verbs means in the absence of helping action verbs, there are always helping verbs. So helping verbs help the main verb to describe action, so that action helped in the past or is happening in the present or will happen in the future. So here in the image, these all given are known as helping verbs. Am, is, are, was, were, being, been, be, has, have, had, did, etc., etc. These all are known as helping verbs. So in this example, Dinah is a doctor. Here there is no action verb. So helping verb you can see, that is. Very good. Is known as a helping verb. So now you have to frame a question on this verb so that you will get a object as an answer. Dinah is what? A doctor. So here in this sentence you are getting a object as an answer. So this is another example of intransitive verb. Now a doctor is not an object. Doctor, you can say doctor as an object? No. But when sometimes in intransitive verbs also you are getting object as an answer. So that is also known as intransitive verb. Clear students? Students, two more examples of transitive verb. First, Louisa threw the ball. So threw is a verb because it is an action. And second thing you have to do, that you have to check whether after verb there is an object or no. So in this sentence, the ball, a ball is an object. It's a direct object. Then you have to ask the question on the verb. What did Louisa threw? The ball. So you are getting object as an answer. So after the verb threw, there is an object. The ball is an object. So, threw is which verb? Transitive verb. Very good. Now, second, Louisa dropped her hat. Dropped is an action. So, dropped is a verb. After verb, you can see object there. Yes, the her hat. So, hat is an object. Hat is a direct object here. So, what did Louisa dropped? Her hat. So, dropped. After the verb drop, there is an object. What is an object? Hat. So, it is known as transitive verb. Dropped is which verb? Transitive verb. Students, now another example of intransitive verb. You can see here. The sun rises in the east. So, what is verb here? Rises. Because rises is an action. Am I right? So, can you see an object over there? No. In the east, we cannot say a direct object. So, rises is an intransitive verb because it does not carry an object after the verb. Let's proceed to the next example. She walks quickly. So, walks is an verb. Walk is a verb because it denotes an action. Now, there is an object after the verb? No. Quickly. Quickly is an object? No. So, walk is known as intransitive verb. Understood, students? So, students, I hope so that you have understood these grammar topic, transitive verbs and intransitive verbs very well. Now, the things which I am telling you all now, just keep in mind and listen carefully. Now, these grammar topic notes, I am sending you all through WhatsApp. So, in your English notebook itself, in the last, you have to make partition by leaving last 15 or 20 pages. So, first step is you have to make the partition in your English notebook by leaving last 15-20 pages for grammar. And in that book, you are supposed to write today's date, your grammar topic, transitive and intransitive verb, and the definition of transitive, intransitive verb I am sending you all along with the examples. So, you have to write in good handwriting in your English notebook. And exercise, in the exercise, I am sending you all few questions. So, that those questions you are supposed to do by yourself. Don't take any help. Just try it so that you can understand whether you have understood this topic very well. Now, first you have to note down the definition along with its example. Second, the exercise questions which I am sending you all through WhatsApp, just write its answer in neat and clean handwriting with pencil so that the next lecture I will send you all those answers. So, just cross check whether you have written the correct answers or not in the next lecture. But by that time, you have to complete those exercises today itself and send me the picture or the image of this topic on my personal number today itself before 6 p.m. We'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you.